Hey guys, welcome back to another video on our YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to mount mirrors on the perch of your handlebars up here. So guys, there's a couple of reasons why we're mounting perch mounted mirrors up here versus the ones that come in the inner fairing on the street glide. If you go to a 10 inch bar like we did, it puts the hand grips and all the controls right in the middle of where the mirror would be. So that was one reason. And then the second reason, we did an inner fairing. We did a painted inner fairing. It's color matched. And it had the holes already blocked in. Now you can drill those out and put your fairing mirrors back in, but since we had already done the 10 inch bars and the inner fairing, I went ahead and decided to go with a perch mounted mirror. So if you guys have watched any of our videos on our YouTube channel, you'll know that we went with a ton of performance machine parts on this bike. We had some Joker machine, Arlen Ness, and performance machine, pretty much all in the slotted series. Everything we got's kind of got like a slotted design to it. With the new mirrors that we're putting on this bike, we decided to go with the performance machine mirrors that have slots just on the arm, guys. So once again, if you've noticed that I've purchased my parts pretty much from the same places, there's a few places online that I get my parts, and this was actually from getlowered.com. We do have the 10 inch LA choppers that came from Get Lowered. We have the Arlen Ness grips that match our air cleaner. We have the Joker machine covers for the clutch and the brake master cylinders up here, all from Get Lowered, guys. And it's just one of those companies that I have a lot of trust in. If you guys have ordered any parts online before and you're dealing with a new company, it's a little iffy sometimes. Just to kind of save you guys a little bit of headache in the future, a good website to check out is getlowered.com. Once again, I'll put the link to that down in the description and you can check out the website and go from there. But that's where these mirrors come from, guys. So I see in the forums quite a bit more than I thought that I would. People asking about how they mounted their mirrors and up on their handlebars on the perch versus putting them on the inner fairing. Guys, all the stock Harley perches like this right here has a hole right here. If you just get up in there and look right in front of your master cylinder, your clutch master cylinder, your brake master cylinder, there is a hole right there. And that hole is for perch mounted mirrors, guys. So what we're gonna do is just get the camera down here and get these installed. This is a very, very easy install. But like I said in my past video, guys, anytime that we do anything to this bike, whether it be little bitty or big, we try to get it on video so you guys can see it. So here's the mirror, guys. I got it out of the package and just want to kind of just flip it around, get it up here, a close up for you. This is the Performance Machine Aero mirror. And of course, right on the end here is an Allen head bolt, so you can loosen this and actually move the mirror this way. And then of course the mirror actually pivots here, and then you have your stem. And by already testing this, guys, I can tell you on the Harley Davidson, this is a 2014 street glide, I'm going to have to use the longer one to get through that really thick perch. With the hole down here, you can mount it with the mirrors going up, or you can mount it with the mirror going down. I had mine up before and they came way up and I just really didn't care for it, guys. So I mounted them down. And this way, with the mirror coming down here and out, I get the question all the time, don't your arms get in the way of seeing in the mirror if this is mounted down here like this? Absolutely not. You just, instead of looking up to look through your mirror, you just look down a little bit and you can still see everything that you need to see. I've had my mirrors mounted down like this for over a year. Absolutely love the way it looks, and it still functions the way it should, and I can still see all of the traffic that I need to see behind me. So the perch bolt up here is a number 6 Allen head, guys. So I'm going to line up my little spacer and put on there and go ahead and get this threaded on. Once we get that mounted, we'll actually have to set the bike down. And this may take a couple of times. Adjusting them in the garage is not quite the same as adjusting them out on the street. If you mount your mirrors upside down like this and you don't want to see this little bolt head up here, you can always top that off with some like those chrome caps. We use those chrome caps pretty much all over the bike and they work great. They cover up all the bolt heads and they're cheap. So if they break or fall off or something, you just grab another one and stick it on there. There's a chrome cap installed right there on top of the button head, so it gives me a nice clean look. Now with this bolt up here, guys, I do recommend that you install a little bit of blue Loctite on the bottom of this one. You know, it's a Harley, they vibrate. You guys, if you own a Harley Davidson or pretty much any motorcycle and you don't have a bottle of blue Loctite, you need to go get some. It's very cheap. It'll last you a long time. A little bit goes a long way. The blue is very easy to break free if you need to get a part off. Now, if you go with the red, that stuff sets up like concrete. So I try to always use the blue. And if you have a little bit of trouble getting it off, you can always take a little pin torch and a little heat and just heat up the area real quick. It'll break that blue loose and you can take that bolt right back out. So once again, a very, very easy install, guys. It shows you how to mount your mirrors on a Perch. You can mount them up or you can mount them down. Visually, it gives you the same whether you mount them up or whether you mount them down. It just all comes down to aesthetics. So how do you want it to look? Do you want them way up here or do you want them down here? Now, guys, when you get onto the website, they are sold individually. So be careful. You're not getting a set of mirrors. They are sold individually. It's a Vision mirror assembly and it's the Aero. This is the ones that we got and they sell different ones. So you can check out the different ones that Performance Machine offers. Like I said, you can get all of these over at getlowered.com. Check that website out. I'll put the link to the description down below. I will also put the exact part number to these mirrors down below as well and a link straight to them on getlowered.com. So that's it, guys. Not a whole lot to that install, but if you have any questions, you guys know the deal. Comments down below. I check YouTube every single day and I'll try to get back to you and help you the best that I can, or at least steer you in the right direction. So check out the channel, guys. Over 80 videos now, how to's, installs, all kinds of good stuff on there. Guarantee you're gonna find something. If you do, please hit that subscribe button, guys. It helps us keep this channel alive. Me and my family appreciate the hell out of all you guys. I love interacting with you guys too in the comments and stuff. So any questions or anything like that, like I said, drop in the comment box and I'll get back to you as quick as I can. But until the next video, guys, as always, be safe, keep your knees in the breeze.